Ralph Havens here. Ralph Havens here. Ralph Havens here. Ralph Havens from the Heart of Running and Mission Hills Physical Therapy. What I'm going to show you all today in this segment is what I'm going to show you all today in this segment are some exercises that on the surface look a little funny, but they're very powerful, and they're from the world of integrative manual therapy, which is a method that was developed and expanded upon by Sharon Giamatteo, physical therapist and PhD in integrative medicine, one of my teachers and mentors for many years, and I've studied with her for over 10 years, about 11 or 12 years. I've taken over 100 classes in integrative manual therapy and become certified in the integrative manual therapy method. And there's many exercises as part of her program that I find useful. Some of them are quite remarkable. The ones I'm going to show you, all of them are quite remarkable. The ones I'm going to show you in this segment are for the pelvis, the urogenital system. And I can give you a brief story of my experience with these. I saw these exercises for many years, but never used them myself. And then one day I had a calf strain. And and it was lasting for more than a few weeks. And Sharon Giamatteo took a look at me, and she said that the biggest part of my problem was in my pelvis. It was a condition that is now known in integrative manual therapy circles as a descended bladder, which just basically meant that the bladder on the left side of my body was pulled down a little bit. What that was doing was causing some tension in my nerves around my sacrum and my low back, and that was putting tension on the nerves that went into the legs, and that was causing my spasm in my calf. So I could have spent a lot of time working on my calf, doing different techniques, stretches, different other methods to loosen up the calf. But what was really going on was the tension on the nerves that went to the calf. And the tension on the nerves that went to the calf was coming from the pelvis, and it was coming because of the pelvic organs. For me, in that case, the bladder.
God.
So Sharon told me to do these exercises and to do them a few times through. So there's a whole book of these exercises, and it's a book called Functional Exercise Program for Women's and Men's Health Issues by Sharon Giamatteo and Tom Giamatteo, her husband, who's a chiropractor and also a physical therapist and a naturopath. So that's what it looks like. You can find it on Amazon.com or by going to centerimt.com. And those links are on our website. But what she told me to do was do that book four times. So it was football season, and I went home and I did the exercises four times through, and my calf strain went away. And what I noticed was that I kept doing the exercises, and what I noticed was that my pelvis started to get very strong. I was doing a lot of Pilates with my friend Kate Cruz at the time, and my hips started to get more loose. They got looser with my Pilates as I was doing these exercises. Within a week or two, I decided to give myself a few months of doing these every day. So I memorized them, and I learned how to do them, and it just took me a few minutes a day. And I did them almost every day for about 5 or 6 months. And my running form improved immensely. My stride length improved, the power and core stability improved in my pelvis and spine. And what happens, I believe, is the core strength in the pelvic girdle and in the pelvic floor gets stronger, so then the hip muscles can relax. So what we're going to do is show you these exercises. You use them, you do them on the toilet and also with different size balls, like a tennis ball or a football or a golf ball. I'll show you with a tennis ball, but you can use it with different size balls. And you also use it with a toilet. So they're a little funny looking, very powerful though. So what I recommend you do is once a day when you're going to the toilet, you spend an extra few minutes doing these exercises. Now I'm not going to show you all the exercises from this book, but they are readily available at centerimt.com. Just go get the book. It's a small booklet, very worth your while. But I'm going to show you some that are, I believe, some of the more powerful exercises in the book. And I'll explain why I think they're powerful. So we're going to head to the restroom, and I'm going to show you how these work. Okay. Okay, you're squishing your bottom down into the toilet. Let's put this back. Okay, you're squishing yourself down into the toilet. The left leg is over the other leg. Here we go. Three sets of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Squish down again. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, squish down again. Squish that bottom down into the toilet as if you're trying to fall through that hole. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we're going to repeat by doing the other leg. So cross the other leg over. Squish yourself down into the toilet, straight down like you're trying to fall through the toilet. Okay, squish down, and here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Squish down again. And here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And one more set. Squish down again. As far down as you can get those sit bones, your pelvic bones, into the toilet bowl. Straight down. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, and now I'm going to get a tennis ball and show you the next section. Okay, the next section, you can do it anywhere. You can do it on a, you can do it on any kind of seat. But since we're here, I'm going to show you with this. And what the book recommends and what I recommend is get three different size balls. I'm going to just show you one, but you'll get the idea. Use a tennis ball, a golf ball, and a football. But you can use different sizes of different kind of balls. It doesn't have to be an actual football. It can be something that's like a football, but about that size. But I'm going to show you with a tennis ball. And all you do is you put the tennis ball between your knees, and you just hold it there. A little squeeze, but not a big squeeze. It's mostly to keep the ball from falling, and you hold it there for a minute. So we'll just hold it there for a minute. And I'm going to open up the book to that page. So you can see that in Sharon's book, she shows a tennis ball, football, and a golf ball. So this is a great book, very self-explanatory, but this exercise is as simple as it looks. You just hold a tennis ball and a golf ball and a football, different size balls for 1 minute each. And I don't need to have a video of just watching me hold a tennis ball or a football or a basketball. I mean, hold a football, a tennis ball, or a golf ball for a minute each to use up video footage. But you get the idea. So you just hold it for a minute. What I recommend is get a tennis ball, a football, a golf ball, or something about that size, and leave it by your couch or the chair that you sit in, and once a day just hold it for a minute with each ball while you watch a little TV or while you're just sitting in a chair reading. Then when you go to the bathroom, once a day, take a little time, and once you're done going to the bathroom, just do the squish the sit bones into the toilet bowl ring exercise. Some with the legs 6 inches apart, some with the legs 12 inches apart, some with the legs crossed, and some with the legs straight out. And you do 3 sets of 10, and combine that with this tennis ball exercise, and you combine it with one other thing. When you go to urinate, stop the flow 3 times. So once a day, stop the flow 3 times. In the beginning, it might feel pretty weird. You might feel like, ooh, this feels like it might not be good for me. But it's just training and exercise, and you should be able to stop and start a natural rhythm like that. Like, you should be able to stop and start your breath. You could, be able to do things like that, and it won't hurt you. But it might feel a little weird in the beginning, but very useful things from this book, the Functional Exercise Program for Women's and Men's Health Issues. And I want to thank Sharon Giamatteo and Tom Giamatteo for letting us use this strange exercise, I know, from the way it looks, but very, very powerful. These exercises will give you a Pilates effect for your pelvis. You'll get more strength, more balance, more flexibility in the hip joints, more core stability, and a lot of pelvic bowl health, different things for your bladder, uterus, prostate. If you're dealing with any issues down there, you're not going to be able to run with a wide open pelvis. And as these clear up, you'll be able to run with a more wide open pelvis. Your hips will be looser. You'll be more powerful. So I encourage you to try it, and give yourself a gift and say you'll do them once a day for the next 6 months, and see what you notice and see what your friends notice. Because if you're like me, your friends will notice that your stride looks better, you look stronger, and you'll feel different when you run. So give those a try. Thank you.